Hello, Airbus Cockpit Coach here. In this video, we're going to look at the memory items for a stall recovery. Now, the Airbus is actually quite a difficult aircraft to stall in normal law. We've got various angle of attack protections, and also the auto thrust system works with us to prevent a stall. It's not impossible, but during our day-to-day operations, when operating the aircraft in normal law, it would be very much unexpected to get a stall. It would be much more likely in alternate law, where we lose our protections through the computers, but however we would not depart the aircraft or dispatch the aircraft in an alternate law state. Something that can occur during a course of a flight due to a number of different failures that can occur, and there's quite a few different failures which can cause a downgrade to alternate law. There are quite a few different failures which could cause a switch from normal law to alternate law, so I won't run through all of those, but one way we can do that is by ourselves, is by taking the ADR computers off. And we've lost our autopilots, disconnected, and we've lost our air data, and we can put the captain side back on to source free. We've also lost auto thrust. And you can tell here on the primary flight display, we haven't got the two green eagle marks here by the side of a bank angle limit, and that's a telltale sign that we're not in normal law. Now, the aircraft can stall at high speed as well as low speed. It's not just a speed related situation. It's more to do with angle of attack. We could be going very fast, but if we have a high angle of attack, the aircraft will still stall. So the actions for stall recovery are the pilot flying to announce stall, I have control. We'd then pitch the nose down, not aggressively. So we'd be putting in a forward input. It can be difficult to nose the aircraft down if it's going particularly fast, and we may need to take thrust off in order to get the nose down. But it's important to know if you're struggling to get a pitch down effect, we need to reduce thrust. We need to ensure the wings are level as well. We'll then increase thrust smoothly. Check that our speed brakes are retracted, and we'll recover our flight path. If we're below 20,000 feet and in a clean configuration, i.e. no flaps deployed, we'd select flap 1, which will put the slats out, and that increases our angle of attack margin of the stall. So basically we can fly at a greater angle of attack. So let's run through that now. We're going to pitch up, bring the power back. See our speed decaying pretty quickly there on the left side of the primary flight display. And this is a reasonably shallow pitch state. We're in at about 6 or 7 degrees pitch up at the moment. Stall, I have control. Pitch the nose down. Ensure those wings are level. Increase thrust smoothly. Watching for an airspeed increase. Check that our speed brakes are retracted. They are. And we're below 20,000 feet. Flaps config 1 selected. When we do that, we obviously need to ensure that we don't overspeed the flaps. We do need to watch that. It was very close to the overspeed margin there. and then we'll recover our flight path. It is possible the aircraft is quite sensitive to then enter into another stall, and would repeat those actions. Important to note that minimising loss of altitude is secondary to reducing the angle of attack in order to regain lift from the wings. So the initial action is to get the nose down. So pitch down, thrust reduction may be necessary if no pitch control authority is available, and get your wings level. As we come out of the stall, apply the thrust smoothly, check your speed brakes are retracted, and recover the flight path. If below 20,000 feet, select flaps 1, but watch that flap limiting speed because the aircraft will be accelerating in its pitch down state. Any questions on that, please drop them in the comments. Please hit the like button if you found that useful. Thanks for watching.